welcome to my December... No. Hello, everybody, and welcome to my November favorites. And I'm going to be totally honest with you guys. November was the worst month ever, and I am so glad it's over. Like, all these other people on YouTube are like, oh my god, November went by so fast. Time flies and you're having fun. And I'm like... It sucked ass. So, this is my first favorite video that I've ever done, and I feel kind of awkward about it, but that's okay. You guys have asked me for it for so long. The past 2 months, I was like, should I? No. But it's like, I need to get over it and just do it. And I do like watching favorite videos myself, so I might as well. You know, it's happening. So here we go. So let's just jump into it because I picked out, I feel like, a lot of stuff, but hopefully it's not overwhelming and I'm gonna try to move really quickly. So I'm gonna start off with skincare because I've been trying some new things this month and I am so in love with them. Okay, first off is the Purity Face Wash by Philosophy. That's it, I'm done. Purity Face Wash by Philosophy. This is the best face wash I think I've ever used. I'm not even kidding. It gets your skin so stinking clean. And like I put like a generous amount on my hand, wet my face, and then I wash my face and it takes off every speck of makeup. And I was noticing that, like, I've talked about it in my skincare video that I had like little bumps and I didn't know what they were and this and that and blah, blah, blah. Anyways, they were basically completely gone, but not totally. And then I got this because I was like, oh, you know, it's supposed to be like really gentle and cleansing, but it's supposed to go deep into the pores and get all the dirt out and bacteria. So I was like, let's give it a shot. Now that I'm using this, my skin has finally hit a new place where it's like, it's doing good. And I think the issue all along was that I wasn't getting my skin as clean as I should. So this is awesome, and it's inexpensive. I went to Lush unplanned, and I've never been like a Lush freak ever in my life, but I just like walked past and I went in and they completely sold me this ocean salt face and body scrub. Oh, look at the little cute man that made it for me. He's so happy. Smells kind of weird and tastes disgusting. It's not edible, so I shouldn't be tasting it in the first place. But this is such an awesome face scrub. I haven't used it on my body because I don't really care. I have other stuff for my body. But I was scared that it was going to break me out because I've used some things from Lush before and they've really irritated my skin. And I don't know why, because it's supposed to be all natural or whatever. But this is awesome. Absolutely love it. I've been using it like 3 to 4 times a week. It's so huge. I feel like it's going to take me months to go through, which is awesome. But I love it. It's one of the best exfoliators I've ever used. And I am not an exfoliator person because I just use sugar to exfoliate my face. This is the only exfoliator I've ever used in my life that has made me change my opinion on that. Next are two Mario Badescu pieces of skincare. The first one, I'll say, it's the Cura Moisturizer. It's for dry and sensitive skin because the more like cool it gets outside, the drier my skin is getting. This is for dry and sensitive, and I just love it. I use it every single day. It's so moisturizing, but I can put it on and then immediately do my makeup. And you know how some moisturizers, it's like you have to put it on and you have to let it sit for at least 15, 20 minutes because it's like sticky, and if you put your makeup on, it'll kind of slide around. Not this one. I put it on and it's like a primer, and I can just go straight with my foundation and it's perfect. Last skincare thing is the Caviar Night Cream. I am obsessed. This is thick stuff. It's like, it doesn't move. Like, see how thick that is? It's like, it's almost like a balm. Like, it's not gonna move. It's thick as can be. You have to like dig your finger in it. And you can definitely feel it on your skin when you put it on. It's not sticky, but you're gonna feel it. It's, you know what I mean. Anyways, I mix this a lot with my Josie Maran Argan Oil. And I just like slather my face in it like 20 minutes before I get into bed. And I'm just like, when I wake up in the morning, I just feel like I have new skin every single morning. I am very extremely happy with my skincare right now. And then one more thing is this little tiny lip balm from Lush. I'm a Burt's Bees most of the time kind of person. I think Burt's Bees does the job in EOS, but this is called Honey Trap, and it's like waxy, but I will put it on before I fall asleep. I will wake up in the morning and it's still on my lips. Like, my lips are still completely and totally moisturized, where normally I literally wake up in the middle of the night and reapply chapstick because I'm that crazy. I have been obsessed with L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation. If you're curious, I'm shade W5, and I am just obsessed with this. Now, this W5 by itself isn't really my color. It's a little too pink. It's the same shade, but not the same tone. It's a little too pink, and it's like, I can get away with it, but not really. So I've been mixing it with MAC's Mineralize Foundation. It's the cream. It looks like so. This is N shade NC35. Really? I thought it was an NC30. Okay. Anyways, I've been using these two together. So I pump this on the back of my hand, and I take my stippling brush, I dab it in the MAC, and then I dab it on the back of my hand, and I just go to work. And it's the perfect color, and it gives me like a natural dewy finish, and it keeps me hydrated all day long. And seriously, props to L'Oreal for this foundation. I'm obsessed with it. It's gorgeous. Then for other things on the face, this Maybelline concealer, I don't know what it's called. It literally just says Maybelline and that's it, but it's the only one that's in this wand packaging, and mine is in shade Fair. It's not the lightest shade, it's the second to lightest shade, and it's that looks like completely nothing, but it's there we go. It's pretty opaque, especially for a drugstore concealer, and I love it. Most of the time I mix it in with my Pro Longwear concealer, which is my favorite concealer of all time, but you can also use it by itself, and it just has like this gentle dewy look, and I love it. It's awesome. It's great for highlighting. So yes, that's been an awesome drugstore favorite of mine. For lipsticks, my favorite lipstick of this month has been Rebel by MAC, and it looks like this. A lot of girls have been giving this a shout out recently. I've seen it on YouTube. I can't talk. And it's like this purple pink. Oh, it is so pretty. And I absolutely love that it's a satin because it doesn't have any frost in it and there's not that much shine. It's just the right amount. I have been wearing it a lot with MAC's Night Moth. I had this in my last makeup tutorial that I did. So Night Moth is pretty dark, but then I put Rebel on over top of it, especially in the center of the lips. Kind of gives you a really nice ombre lip with the really dark purple and the lighter pinker purple. This eyeliner by NARS, and I cannot pronounce this to save my life. Rue Bonaparte. Anyways, it's just, I used this in my last video too because I've been using it all the time. It's a cream color. So it's not white, it's the color of your skin, and it looks so great in the waterline with whatever you're wearing. It just opens up your eyes so bright. I love it. It looks good with every color. Re-in love with this. I used to love this mascara, and then I stopped for a while, and now I'm back. So it's the MAC False Lashes Mascara. Now, I'm not a believer in having to buy high-end mascaras at all. All my mascaras are from the drugstore. I have a few from MAC, but this one I am obsessed with for the bottom lashes only. Because I have really long bottom lashes, so this may not apply to a lot of you, but like most mascaras, when I put on my bottom lashes, it just clumps up and like sticks together, or it doesn't get on my lashes, and it's wrong in all the right ways. So this, I just love this mascara for my bottom lash line. The wand looks like this. I have it bent to the side. This is not what your wand will look like when you get it, but when I apply my mascara, I bend my wand, and then I apply it like this because it's easier to maneuver with my hands. And then when I put it back in the tube, I just straighten it out. So yes, MAC False Lashes. MAC Pro Longwear Lip Glasses. Oh my gosh, I saved the best for last. I'm wearing this one right now. This is Infinitely Lickable. Infinitely Lickable. So I don't need to swatch it for you because you can see it is on my lips. And then this one is Forever Rose. And this one I have on my lips at the end of my fall makeup tutorial. There's like a picture I have at the very end. It's right there, but you can see, like, if you dip it in there, you can see how opaque these are. Like, yeah, they don't mess around. And they're Pro Longwear. They're supposed to last for an extended amount of time, and they literally do. They stay glossy all day, and they stay on all day. And I don't understand how, but they're, like, they're creamy, and they're shiny, and they're on for hours. And, like, I don't have to retouch my lips. Like when I work an 8-hour shift, I only have to put it on when I go in and then after my lunch break, and that's it. It just stays on all day, even with all the talking that I'm doing. So I'm happy about that. My last thing I want to mention here is necklaces. These came out at Nordstrom for Black Friday. They still have them and they are still online. They were our doorbusters, and these are like Shazam necklaces, okay? Yes, I do not want to wear it in this video because I have a light behind me and it's going to blind you guys like with the sparkle, but they're gorgeous, and everyone that I work with bought them like in every single color, and they just sparkle and they scream holiday. So I got one in that color, and then I also got one in this color. Now oh gosh, yes. You would not believe the price, and that's why I'm mentioning them, because they are from Nordstrom, and they are, can you see? That's right, 28, $28 for these necklaces. And honestly, if it was any other time of the year and these necklaces came out, they'd be like $50-$60. But they're $28. I love them. They have them in hot pink, an emerald green, silver. I don't remember. Anyways, they're gorgeous. So that's that. I hope you enjoy. So that's it for this video, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Mwah!